This is DSV, SSV, SC amplitude modulation and demodulation trainer. Order code of this trainer is 40516. Different blocks are provided on the panel. These are the different amplifier, modulator and demodulator section. First block is input audio amplifier section. A detailed circuit diagram of this section is also provided. This is TBA810IC. This is volume control knob. This is the socket. This is the jack for mic. This is second block, double balanced amplitude modulator section. And this is the circuit diagram of this section. And this is your product detector block. Fourth block is audio frequency modulating signal generator block, and this is the amplitude variable knob. You can vary the amplitude of audio frequency 0 to 5 volt peak to peak value, and this is the frequency variation. You can vary the frequency of audio frequency from 300 Hz to 3.4 kHz, and this is the output terminal of this section, and this is your DC source. You can study the DC as a modulating input, effect of DC as a modulating input, effect of DC on the output. And this is your diode detector block, and this is the toggle switch which will be used in experiment to obtain the different waveform. This is your 6th number block. This is band pass filter input. This is the input terminal of this section. This is the output terminal of this section. And this is local oscillator and frequency variable knob. You can vary the frequency of this local oscillator with the help of this knob, 4 kHz to 500 kHz. And this is your low pass filter. IC741 is used in this filter. This is radio frequency carrier signal oscillator, and this is the detailed circuit diagram of this section. And with the help of this knob, you can vary the amplitude of this RF carrier 0 to 10 volt peak to peak, and this is the frequency variable knob. You can vary the frequency of this radio frequency with the help of this knob, 100 kHz to 1 MHz, and this is the power supply block, and this is the terminal for plus 15 volt power supply. This is minus 15 volt. All sections are internally connected to this power supply block, and this is the plus 5 volt power supply output. This is audio output audio amplifier section, and this is the volume control knob, and this is the jack for external speaker. We can connect the external speaker to this jack pin, jack socket. So different experiments are given in our manual. So according to the first experiment is amplitude modulation and demodulation with the help of this trainer. So first object is to generate AM signal, amplitude modulated signal, by modulating with audio signal generator. For this object, this is your audio frequency modulating signal generator, and this is the output of this section. So connect the output of this section to the modulating input terminal of double balanced amplitude modulator section, and this is the RF oscillator output, and connect the output of this RF oscillator to the carrier input of double balanced amplitude modulator section. And this is your CRO probe, and connect your CRO probe between the ground terminal and output of section 2, block 2. And this is the ground terminal. Connect this ground terminal to any ground terminal of the trainer. and this is the positive lead of CRO, and connect this positive lead to output amplitude modulated output of block number second. Switch on the trainer, adjust the amplitude of audio frequency, and another connection is this plus one link in balanced amplitude modulator section. Connect this knob, this lead, and this is your amplitude modulated waveform. So this is your experiment first, object first of experiment one, to study the amplitude modulated waveform, and this is your amplitude modulated waveform diagram, W3 AM modulated output signal, and on the CRO you can see the amplitude modulated signal, which is equal to waveform number 3. So now we are going to second object is to measure modulation index of AM signal. So you can measure the modulation index with the help of this waveform, with the help of CRO. This is your V minimum and this is your V maximum. So using the formula you can calculate the modulation index. Object third is to demodulate AM signal using diode detector, and this is the block of diode detector. Sixth block is diode detector block. So connect the output. This is the output of double balanced amplitude modulator section. So connect this output. This is TP2. So connect this TP2 to AM modulated input of block number 6. So now amplitude modulated waveform is connected to diode detector section, and observe the output with the help of CRO at the output terminal of this section. And this is the output terminal of this section. So according to the manual, keep RC time switch, this is your RC time switch in diode detector at C21. Now this is side to C21. Keep variable potentiometer in diode detector at fully clockwise position. This is potentiometer. Keep this fully clockwise position, and you can see the waveform. This is your fifth waveform, and on CRO screen you can see this waveform. Vary the input oscillator frequency and amplitude. Also vary the RC time constant in the diode detector by selecting different capacitor. This is different capacitor, and this is the audio frequency variation, and this is the amplitude of audio frequency variation, and this is the time constant variation, RC time constant variation with the help of this knob. Observe diagonal clipping and negative clipping waveform W6 and W7. This is W6 waveform, this is W7 waveform, this is 7th number waveform, this is 6th number waveform. So for this waveform, adjust the amplitude of audio frequency, audio signal, and keep this switch to center position. This is C21, this is C22, and this is your center position. This is C21, this is center, this is C20. So keep this switch to center position, and with the help of this knob, you can observe the sixth and seventh waveform. This is your sixth waveform, 4k7 resistance only, and this is your seventh waveform. For this waveform, this is your seventh waveform, 4k7 resistance and 4.7 nanofarad capacitor. This is ninth waveform, diagonal peak clipping. You can see on the CRO, this is your diagonal clipping waveform. Tenth number of waveform, this is your tenth waveform. With the help of amplitude variable knob of audio frequency, with the help of RC time switch, with the help of 100k potentiometer, potentiometer, fifth potentiometer, you can observe the different waveform from diode detector block. Now, negative peak clipping. This is your negative peak clipping. Eleventh waveform. This is your negative peak clipping waveform. On the CRO you can see this is your negative peak clipping. Object 4th is to generate voice signal AM modulation and demodulation using mic. Now we are going to do object 4th of experiment first, and this is your mic. Disconnect the diode detector block, and this is your mic. Connect this mic at the jack, which is in input audio amplifier. And this is the speaker connect this speaker to, this is your socket for external speaker, and this is the input terminal of this block. Connect this input terminal to the output of diode detector. This is the output of diode detector. So now your detected signal is connected to input terminal of audio amplifier, output audio amplifier. This is amplitude modulated output which is connected to diode detector section, and with the help of this is on off. This is audio frequency signal generator. Disconnect this audio frequency signal generator and connect the input terminal of second block to the output terminal of first block. This is the output terminal of this first block. Now mic section is connected to modulator section, and modulator section is connected to demodulator section. This is diode detector, and this diode detector is connected to output audio amplifier. So now this is your, this is your voice signal generation with the help of amplitude modulation and demodulation, and this is your mic and this is your speaker. So now audio signal is generated by this mic, and audio signal amplitude modulated by this second number section, and demodulate by sixth number section, diode detector section, and then output is converted to again audio signal with the help of this output audio amplifier section. So this is your fourth object of experiment. First, to generate voice signal amplitude modulation and demodulation using mic. Another object of this experiment first is to observe the effect of DC signal input on AM output. So now we are going to object fifth of experiment first, and this is observe the effect of DC signal. Disconnect the audio output and connect this modulating input section of block second to DC source. This is the output of this DC source. So we have connected this output of this DC source to the modulating input terminal of block second. So now your DC signal is connected to modulating input terminal of double balanced amplitude modulator section. Disconnect the output of detector section from output audio amplifier section, and this is your amplitude modulated output which we have connected the diode detector section. So now diode detector block is disconnected, and this is the output of block second, and we have connected this output to CRO. Switch on the trainer. This is your carrier, and your knob is, this is fully anti-clockwise. This knob is fully anti-clockwise, means minus 5 volt. Now we are rotating it to clockwise direction. and output DC is increasing minus 5 volt to plus 5, and see the effect of output waveform. See the effect this DC at output waveform, and this is the effect of DC input at the output section, output waveform. Observe the effect of DC signal input on AM output. This is your AM output and this is your DC signal. Now at this time this is in minus 5 volt position and we are increasing. When we are increasing it to positive side, to plus 5 volt size side, you can observe the effect of this DC input at the output waveform of second block. So this is the effect of DC at the amplitude modulated output waveform. So this is your object 5 of experiment first. Now we are going to object 6 of experiment first. This is to demodulate AM signal by square law detection. For this experiment, this is your CRO knob, CRO lead, and this is your DC source. Connect, this is your modulating input lead. Connect this lead to audio output terminal. Now your audio frequency generator is connected to modulating input terminal of second block, and this is amplitude modulated output. Connect this amplitude modulated output to third block. Third block is your product detector block. So connect the output of second block to the input of product detector block, and this is your RF carrier output which is already connected to second block. And now we are going to connect this RF output to third block also. Now RF oscillator, RF carrier signal oscillator is connected to second block and third block both. So this is the connection for sixth object of experiment first, to demodulate AM signal by square law detection. And this is the output terminal of this block. This is product detector block and this is the output terminal. So connect this CRO lead to this output terminal of this block, and waveform is given in our manual at this output terminal. This is 12. This is the waveform which is the output of this product detector block. Switch on the trainer, and this is your the output of this product detector block. This is your CRO lead. Connect this CRO lead to the output of this product detector block, and this is your output of this product detector block. So we have demodulated AM signal by square law detection, and waveform is matched to 12th number of waveform which is given in our manual. Vary the audio input oscillator frequency and amplitude and see its effect on detected output signal. With the help of this knob, you can vary the amplitude of the audio frequency, and you can vary the frequency of this audio signal with the help of frequency variable knob, which is in audio frequency modulator section, fourth section. vary RF carrier oscillator frequency and amplitude and observe its effect on the AM modulated signal. And this is the frequency variation of RF carrier section. So observe the effect of this frequency variation on the output of this product detector section. And this is the amplitude of RF carrier, and see the effect of this amplitude variation. This is the amplitude variation of RF carrier section, RF signal. So see the effect of, you can see the effect of RF carrier amplitude, RF carrier frequency, audio frequency amplitude, audio signal frequency on the output of product detector section, on the output of demodulated output, which we have got from square law detection method. So now we are going to experiment second, and experiment second, there are two objects of this experiment: to generate DSB SC AM signal, and second object of this experiment is to demodulate DSB SC signal using product detector. So now we are going to experiment second, DSB SC amplitude modulation and demodulation. To generate DSB SC AM signal, connect the audio output of fourth block to the modulating input terminal of second block. Connect RF output to RF carrier input of this second block. Connect the CRO at the output terminal, and with the help of this amplitude knob and with the help of amplitude of RF carrier, on the CRO you can see this is your DSB SC. This is your DSB SC AM signal. See the effect on DSB SC AM modulated signal by varying the audio oscillator frequency and amplitude. With the help of this knob, you can vary the amplitude of this audio frequency, and you can see the effect of this audio frequency on the output of DSB SC signal. And this is the frequency variation, and see the effect of this frequency variation at the output of second block. We are varying the frequency of audio signal generator section. Vary RF carrier oscillator frequency and amplitude. This is your RF carrier section, and this is the amplitude variation knob, and this is the effect of this amplitude variation on the output waveform. This is the frequency variation of radio frequency, and this is the effect of this frequency variation of RF oscillator and the output section. So observe the effect of radio frequency, amplitude of this radio frequency, observe the effect on output waveform by varying the audio frequency amplitude and frequency of this AF signal generator section, and study the DSB SCM signal. Second object is to demodulate it, to demodulate DSB SC signal using product detector. So for this experiment, connect this RF output to RF input terminal of product detector, and this is your CRO. Connect this output of second block to the input of third block, and CRO is connected to output of product detector. And this is the output of this product detector, and waveform is, this is 13th waveform DSB SC modulated signal, and this is the output of product detector block. And on the CRO you can see the waveform of demodulated DSB SC signal. You can connect this output to the low pass filter also. This is the output of product detector, and this is the input of low pass filter, and this is the output of this low pass filter. And you can see the output. This is your output waveform of low pass filter section, and this is your received modulating signal, which is the output of low pass filter section. Vary the audio input oscillator frequency and amplitude. This is the audio frequency, and vary this audio frequency and see the effect on the output waveform, the received signal waveform, and this is the amplitude variation of audio frequency oscillator, and see the effect of received signal. See the effect on received signal by varying the amplitude knob in AF modulating signal generator section. Vary the RF carrier frequency and amplitude. This is RF carrier amplitude variation, and this is RF carrier frequency variation. See the effect of frequency and amplitude of RF carrier on the received signal waveform. Now disconnect the link between RF output terminal of RF oscillator and RF input terminal of product detector. We have disconnect the RF input and RF output terminal of RF carrier signal generator. This is RF input of terminal of product detector section, and this is the RF output terminal of this RF carrier signal generator section. And connect this RF input to local oscillator output. This is your local oscillator output. Now observe recovered output at demodulated output of product detector. It will not be proper signal and will contain harmonics. This is your CRO probe. Connect this probe to demodulated output of product detector. vary gain condenser sharply to get proper output. We are trying to get proper output. Now, frequency of this RF carrier section is 453 kHz. With the help of this gain capacitor, we are trying to get a proper signal from product detector section. Vary gain condenser sharply to get proper output. It will be difficult to set, but at one time proper output will be available. When RF carrier frequency of RF oscillator and that of local oscillator are same in frequency and phase, this explains synchronization of local oscillator with RF oscillator. So, with the help of this gain condenser, we are trying to get proper output. This is your perfect output. At this time, frequency and phase of local oscillator is same as frequency and phase of RF carrier. So this is the proper output or product detector using local oscillator. Repeat voice modulation and demodulation experiment similar to experiment number 1. So this explains synchronization of local oscillator with RF oscillator. And this is your second object of experiment second. To demodulate TSB-SC signal using product detector and the synchronization of local oscillator with RF oscillator and getting proper output of product detector. This is your perfect output of this product detector. And frequency and phase matched with RF carrier frequency phase, you can get the proper and better output. So this is your experiment second. Object third is SSB-SC amplitude modulation and demodulation. For this experiment, experiment third is SSB-SC amplitude modulation and demodulation. For this experiment, to generate SSB-SC AM signal, connect audio output to modulating input terminal of balance modulator, and this is your RF output. Connect this RF output to input of balance modulator section. This is the output. This is your band pass filter. Connect the output of this balanced modulator section to the input of band pass filter and connect your CRO at the output terminal of this band pass filter. This is the output of this band pass filter. Switch on the trainer. The output of this filter is SSB-SC signal with the help of this frequency variation knob of RF carrier. We are adjusting the carrier frequency. This is now approximately 455 kilohertz. The output of this filter is SSB-SC signal as it filters 455 kilohertz carrier signal. This waveform is similar to DSB-SC waveform. You can see on the CRO, this is similar to DSB-SC waveform on CRO in time domain, but it is different in frequency domain and can be seen only on a spectrum analyzer. So use spectrum analyzer for the observation of this SSB-SC signal. Third object of this experiment is to demodulate SSB-SC signal using product detector. This is your product detector. Connect the output of this band pass filter. This is the output of this band pass filter. Connect this output to input of product detector. And this is your RF output. And connect this RF carrier to the input of balance input of product detector section. and connect the output of this product detector to the input of low pass filter, and this is your CRO. Connect CRO to the output of this low pass filter. Start varying RF carrier frequency from 100 kHz to 460 kHz. Carefully observe the output on CRO. The proper maximum peak signal demodulated sine wave will be available only at 2 carrier frequency. So now we are going to increase the carrier frequency on CRO screen. You can see demodulated sine wave will be available only at 2 carrier frequency. This is your first carrier frequency and this is your second carrier frequency. Again, this is your first carrier frequency. Increasing, 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 and this is your second carrier frequency. So you can see demodulated sine wave is available only at 2 carrier frequencies. This due to passing of upper sideband and lower sideband at 2 different frequency of RF carrier. The theory for this step is given in our manual. So you can study the manual for the reason of the output at 2 carrier frequencies. And this is the detailed explanation of this reason. When audio frequency is 3 kHz and RF frequency is 450 kHz, then output frequency of product detector is first 453 and second 447 kHz. 453 kHz upper sideband and 447 kHz is lower sideband. When these frequencies passes through band pass filter of bandwidth 452 to 458 kHz, 453 kHz upper side band will pass and 447 kHz lower side band will not pass. Hence, one peak output will be available at upper side band. When audio frequency is 3 kHz and RF frequency is 458 kHz, then output frequency of product detector is 458 plus 3, 461 kHz upper sideband and lower sideband is 455 kHz. When these frequencies passes through band pass filter of bandwidth 452 to 458 kHz, 461 kHz upper sideband will not pass and 455 kHz lower sideband will pass. Hence, second peak output will be available at lower sideband. So you can see on the CRO this is your first frequency at which maximum output is available and this is your second frequency at which again maximum output is available. So you can study the demodulation of SSB-SC signal using product detector, and this is the frequency variation knob of audio frequency generator. You can vary the frequency, you can set the frequency of this audio signal at 3 kHz, and you can set the radio frequency with the help of this knob at 100 to 460 kHz. So you can study the detailed explanation of this region with the help of our manual, and you can find the region of this two frequency output. So this is your experiment third. With the help of this trainer, we have studied the DSP, SSP, SC amplitude modulation and demodulation. And trainer is DSP, SSP, SC amplitude modulation and demodulation trainer. Order code of this trainer is 40516. So with the help of this trainer, you can study the different amplitude modulation and demodulation. Thank you.